We talked about how to throw this bowl all the same size so they stack and are very tidy and very nice. What we have to talk about now is this little bowl's bottom. We have to make sure the bottoms are all the same size. I use the same calipers to measure the bottoms as I do measure the top. I've got my 4.5-inch caliper. I'm just going to measure. Now this is already centered. I have it centered. It's level this way and it's centered this way. And now I want to make a foot that is 4.5 inches. So all I'm going to do is the same 4.5 inches I used to measure it this way, I'm now measuring my foot that way. And it's 4.5 inches. Now I know where to trim to. I'm going to trim that off to that mark. I like to define that mark by dropping it down. This is why I like to, when I am throwing, to leave clay here. It gives me a lot of freedom to make a definite foot. I like my bowls to stand on the table and go, I'm standing here. They have to have presents. Not Christmas presents, just they have to have a stance. So then I have a bit of a foot, I undercut it. And I undercut the foot this way, one, because I like what it looks like, but two, when I'm glazing this bowl, if I want to displace the edge, I've got something to hang on to. I make that a tidy blend into that. Undercut it this way, undercut it that way, and now I'm going to just put a little edge in there and cut that tiny. You never want to see where your trimming ends and your throwing starts. I'm going to seal all those edges off and make that tidy. There's trimming the bowl. Now all my foots are going to be 4.5 inches. I'll take this off with a bit. I'll turn it upside down on a board and it will dry. But this is now your bowl. You have control over the inside, the outside. If you want to measure the height, it usually happens because you've controlled all those other things. You have control over the size of its bottom. These will now stack in your cupboard and they'll be great pasta bowls.